Buying a new CNC machine is tough, but buying a used CNC machine, oh my God, that's a whole different world.
Joe, where are we at?
We're still good. We're still underneath our max bid.
Is it done yet?
No. The other guy bid. We got two more minutes.
It's pretty high, Trev.
All right, one more time. I have a limit.
But is it real? Trevor, is it real?
It's physically real. I don't know if it's going to make good parts or not.
I don't know if I want it anymore, Trev.
Oh, you want it. You'll be so happy once it gets here. You'll have no regrets. Oh, no regrets whatsoever.
No regrets.
Now, after that emotional roller coaster ride, we've done it over, and we won the auction. We now have a used machine inside our facility. I'm going to tell you what we went through and the process it took to actually buy a machine off an auction site. Historically, we've always stuck to buying brand new CNC machines. You always know what you're going to get. They come with a warranty. The machine manufacturers come in and do the installation for you. They do on-site training. Everything's cut and dry. You minimize as much risk as possible by doing that. But it comes with a price. We had a situation where we wanted a machine that was identical to the machines that we already had. In this case, it was an A32. Problem was, is this model was discontinued. They no longer manufactured it. So we still wanted one because they've been ideal for our business. They're a core competent machine. We like what they offer us. With that being said, we took to the intranets to see what we could find and see what's for sale out there on the web. And scouring, there's lots of auction sites. There's lots of places that you can find equipment for sale. Came across an auction website with this machine and started reading through all the different sexy features that this machine had, and it was exactly what we were looking for. Happened to be this machine sitting right behind me. And so we had to do our homework. And the first step was to physically go look at the machine. So we went over to the other side of the state. We did our full inspection, checked everything we could, checked to make sure everything was functioning, working the way they said that it was, checked for wear, other premature issues that may become problems later on, and the machine looked legit, the best we could tell. We couldn't physically make a part on the machine, the shop was closed. All we could really do was move the machine around and throw some indicators in it. Next was to get ready for the actual auction. We had a couple weeks, so I spent some time actually putting together a fair market evaluation. So I went on the internet, looked at other machines that were a similar age, what they were selling for, what they had sold for, and I put a value for the machine as well as everything that came with the machine. In this case, it was just a handy dandy little Excel spreadsheet. Put all those costs together and I said, okay, what would be our max bid that we would want to bid on this machine once the auction goes live? One thing to keep in watch for is what the buyer's premium is going to be. These auctioneers are gonna charge you a percentage for buying this machine. In this case, it was 18%. So I had to factor what that was gonna be into the overall cost of my bid to make sure I wasn't paying too much for the machine, and waited. We waited for that auction. And when that auction went live, you saw what Mike was doing behind me and pacing. But I had my boundaries set. I knew what my max bid was gonna be and I wasn't gonna go a bit over it. So one of the things that we were kind of watching for, we were concerned with when we were looking for a machine is, how the hell are we gonna get it here? So a couple things that came with that. One, I didn't really shop for anything that was on the other side of the country, which you can, they're all over the world. I tried to find something that was 4 to 6 hours away, something that we could drive to and from, we can inspect ourselves, and that wasn't gonna cost me a fortune in trucking to get it brought over. The last item was, how do I get it out of the facility that I'm buying it from? In this case, they had a mandatory fee that I had to pay of $1,000 by their rigger to physically move it out of that facility onto a semi. So I had to coordinate a semi to get to that facility within a certain date for them to come in and load that machine. But I had to prepare that machine for them to be able to pick it off the ground. It still had electrical hooked to it, it still had air hooked to it, all the tanks were still there. So we had to go ahead of time and get the machine prepped, get our axes supported, get everything structurally sound, for their riggers to come in, pluck it, and place it. So with that being said, I had to set up a trucker, an LTL trucker from their destination to ours. I had to work with their riggers to get it off their floor onto that semi, and then I had to work on getting it off that semi once it got here into our facility. All things that I had to put in consideration when we were going through this whole process. Something to keep in mind if you ever go down this road. As soon as the machine got brought in, got put in place, we immediately started stripping it down, doing our full inspection, catching all the maintenance up on it, make sure there are no glaring issues or anything. And so far, what we see is we got a solid deal. We got a good deal. But for anybody that's out there looking to do this, you have to be super careful because there's a lot of other costs, inefficiencies, time, and expenses that are gonna be hitting you at the bottom line to take your good deal or your solid deal and make it just someone else's good deal. So do your homework. Make sure the machine's in good shape. Go physically put your hands on that machine, do your inspection. Make sure you understand what the rigging requirements are gonna be getting it out of the other facility and into your facility. Understand what you need to do to this machine once it hits your floor to make sure everything's good. Because as soon as that auction's done, they're gonna want their money and they're gonna want that machine out of that space. It's done, it's yours forever until you do something else with it and it's gotta move. All in all, don't be scared of the used market, but do your homework and do your research before you go out and just buy something. For more tips and tricks, come check out our YouTube page.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe, because you're already watching our YouTube page. And I messed that up again, because you're already there. You're already watching me. All you have to do is like it, so you keep watching more of me.
You should.
You should, I like it, I love it.